red spade that had stolen it. Definitely not in here anywhere. And that was the last red spade. And they've seen it and they pinched it this morning when I wasn't looking. The bastards. So, right, let's go and catch this fibre for Yorkshire. Cracked it. Hi Bruce, yes, I've got air in the green one. You can send the sponge. Sponge is coming. This is what you've got to film, the sponge coming. Most exciting bit. We used to use pop bottles, but we got a bit drenched sometimes, so somebody come up with this bright idea of using an onion sack. So you can catch the sponge and the water just goes whoosh.
Coming down in a minute, okay, Chris. Bye.
Okay, over. Two sponges, Bruce, on my way. Grab the sponges. This is the bit that's live now.
And those are the optics for the customers we're blowing today.
In 2003 we started with Lancashire University building Wi-Fi mesh in the village, and then we built a Wi-Fi mesh for the farmers. All the people down the valley there couldn't get broadband at all. They were 11 kilometres from an exchange, and so they're all fed from here with Wi-Fi. So then all the people at the other side of the valley, they wanted to join our mesh. And we couldn't see them because of these hills and the trees. And Barry Ford got involved when he retired. He came up with this brainwave to get fibre to these people, real fibre to them. And that's when we turned to the people and we said, do you want to build it? Do you want to raise the money yourselves? And that's when Barn was born.
When we did the first plan in 2011, it was fairly modest. It was about 8 parishes, which is sort of about the middle of that plan. What happened was, as soon as we actually started going active and people saw things happening, the next parishes along, and these ones around the corner and those ones up there, they all started saying, why can't we join in? What's not showing on here is we've now crossed the motorway and we're doing Silverdale, which is an area of outstanding natural beauty.
Hello, good to see you.
Well, you know Tim. Do you know Nigel? Well,
I think we've briefly met.
Yes,
but fleetingly.
These two were the ones that really got things going here.
Well, for me, it started at the Story, you know, the institute where the barn had its first meeting in 2011.
Yes.
I fetched up there and it seemed like a good idea.
I
set up a business in Silverdale at the beginning of 2012,
right.
On the understanding that BT were going to be bringing Infinity to the area in September of that year.
It
didn't happen, and it hasn't happened yet.
Slippage, yes.
Their promises come and go, and you know, we've just had to take matters into our own hands.
Well, that seems to be exactly the prevailing idea, isn't it? Let's just get something done.
Yeah.
And people are actually doing it, and it's really exciting.
We very much have the mentality of, we'll just do it.
It is about digging and then tea and cake, but here, there's so much rock.
We're just going to go straight to the cake.
We're led to believe that only really big corporate organisations could possibly do something as high tech as this.
Yeah, and that's actually unfortunate,
isn't it? Simple of things to get it into the ground, and it isn't rocket science, really.
No.
Because it's brought us together.
This is all going to be for you, Will Simpson.
We've already got the spade. You can help us, Steve. You can put a bit more effort in there.
Wow.
We award these to outstanding people or communities, and we write on them, and then we ask them to hang them in prominent places so that people can say, what's that silly spade doing there? We write JFDI, it stands for Just F in Do It, and then we write B4RN, which stands for Broadband for the Rural North, and then the village. And what the villagers have to do is look after these spades, because there are spade thieves about, because they are now collector's items, these spades. So that's the story of the spades.
Even on one of the houses that's on live, you can see the benefits. But half of these people here have been digging for 18 months and they're not live yet. So, sort of, all for one and one for all malarkey.
Just track it over complete.
Andy!
This is a new ducting that we're adding to the trench.
So this is the stuff that holds the fibre optic.
That's a special gadget that pumps that in.
We are the lowest of the food chain. The fibre optic boys are a bit higher up. They come along afterwards and do their bit.
We're the labouring class.
We are very much the labouring class. I think an awful lot of us used to know each other. I mean, I've lived across the road from Mike for about 30 odd years, but when people fall over in the mud and lose the wellies, it's a sort of bonding experience in that.
We can contribute in all sorts of different ways. We can dig, or we can make tea, or we can invest, or however we are able to do it. I've chosen to be a digger, being out in all weather and getting stuck in the mud and having a laugh and a bit of social life, and yeah, it's been very good.
Originally, BT wouldn't release the postcodes where they were going to work because it was apparently commercially sensitive information.
They always said they would only be able to do 96% of coverage. So, but they would never say who the 4% were that they couldn't reach. We suspected, being in the middle of nowhere in Dolphin Home, that it might be us. So got involved, invested, started digging, and lo and behold, 2 years later, we have a super fast broadband network in Dolphin Home.
Nothing against the BT themselves, they're a bit of competition. But it's nice if you can get one over on the big boys.
We've been a team at Wennington trying to complete the fibre network around Wennington. We've been at it for about 9 months, and we're getting towards the last stages now. Some of the last blowing is called, putting the fibre inside the ducting. And as it goes in the ducting, it's going in with compressed air. Usually we can get about 500-700 metres before it gets too much. At that point there, either we're at somewhere where we can get hold of this at a chamber, or we've got to find the end and just dig it out and start this process all over again. BT have not been able to deliver anything to the house that I live in better than 0.7 coming down. I'm now connected where we've got the full facility of barn. It's like coming out of a dark cave into daylight for people who have not had that speed on internet.
Do you want to see my speed test? Let's have a do. Test again. My highest upload is over 800. Looks like it's going to be 600 and some this time. So this is where we are now at our house, Higher Broadwood Farm, and that's the route we're on that carries on all the way up to Loghill. That's the other route that carries on all the way up to Loghill. And just that looks quite impressive. But then when you zoom out, that is Wennington, Arcombe, all the way up to Silverdale up there, all the way down to Quorma there, Dolphin Home.
We started out just doing this unprotected in a field, then we moved up to a little portable tent, and then to this thing. Unfortunately, splicing fibre should be a very clean process. Ideally, the fibre would have come in and left again on its journey, but the resistance in the duct got too much, so they had to stop blowing, leave the fibre here and blow another one to meet it. Of course, you then end up with two ends of the cable. And so we're just going to join the ends together to make it a single cable.
It's not easy. Look at this.
There's
12 there.
12 little colours.
I always ask Alistair which is the
pink
or
grey.
Or grey. Mm-hmm. I can't.
It's always nice when you connect someone up and they say, oh, I can actually try out this BBC iPlayer thing, because it's still new to a lot of people out here, because they're like, oh, this is fantastic. And I can ditch BT, which is normally the second line of after thank you very much.
Everybody wants that. Well, we haven't had a BT connection for a fortnight now, so work from where I live. And they send a different engineer out each time.
On a 2-hour slot or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, but we still haven't got.
He'll do his bit, make a report, file the report. No one will read the report, which is what they've all told me. And then the guy will come out next day and start over from the square one again. Test my phone. Yep, that works. Move down to the pole. Yep, that works. Ooh, it must be up the road.
Our technology is better, isn't it? We can say exactly where it's broken.
Oh, perfect. There you go. So this gives connectivity to everyone, doesn't matter how far away you are. And you get the full speed even if you're right at the end of the line. It's still a gigabit for now anyway. Because when it comes to upgrade time, we just remove the kit either end and stick new kit on, and that's it. Upgrade done. 10 gig, 40, whatever we want.
So it's future proof.
Yeah.
Just a bit of a rush now to get everything packed up before it goes dark, and then the volunteers can go home. And this is what we do every day of the week, and we've been doing this for 3 years now, so we've got 400 kilometres of this stuff in now, and we've got 800 customers online. So you get the same upload as download. That's what people want these days, because they're not content just to consume stuff, they want to create stuff. And, you know, what's the point in making a film if you can't get it up there to show people? Once we've got the upload, we'll see more innovation coming out of the rural areas. The next Mark Zuckerberg could be a fanboy, that's the way I look at it. Right, I'm going to mine this damn pothole again. Otherwise, we bottom out and you're walking home, lads. Ooh, right, be good. There you go, home sweet home again. What have you been doing? It's locked there, Martin, just there. Competition as to who's going to drive me van. And he says, are the keys in it? I said, well, who's going to pinch that? Oh,